Welcome back to another Scriptcase tutorial. Fred here from Scriptcase, and today we're going to see the fixed column options within the grid and summary of Scriptcase. Alright, so the option that we're going to see today is the fixed columns. This option is really useful for large grids like this. Basically, we need to pin or select one option, and then we just need to scroll to see or fix our columns. So let's fix those two. Let's scroll here horizontally. And we are not losing the titles and we are not losing any information of our screen. This option is also available into mobile devices. So we'll look something like this. And let's see how easy it is to use it. So here I am at my development environment. I'm editing here the grid module. In this case, we have enabled the fixed label, which allows me to fix all the titles of my grid. So the second option here is called fixed columns. This is the new one. So let's click yes here and let's run our application. So once you enable this option, you will see this pin right here. So we can start to pin one or more columns. So we're going to fix those two, for example, and let's scroll here horizontally, and that's it. Pretty useful and pretty simple to enable it. Let's check the other options. So the second option is the fixed column hover. Basically, we can hide or remove from the standard view these pins right here. And let's enable this option. Let's run our application. And we don't have any more of those pins again. We only can see or use these pins when we hover the mouse. All right. So this is a pretty good option, allowing us to have a better looking grids. All right. Let's take a look to the other options. All right. Then we have this option here called Fixed Option column, which allows us to fix the options of my grid, for example, the detail and the edit button. So let's click yes here and let's see how our application looks like. So the first column, the option column actually, right now if I scroll here horizontally, I don't have the pin, so it is really fixed by default. So I can actually only fix manually the columns. Okay. Finally, we have here the group by options. So in this case, I didn't enable. The purpose is just to show you the difference. So let me scroll this horizontally. And as you can see, all the group by labels are missing. All right. So let me enable this option. It's pretty simple as well. Just click here at yes, fix it group by. Let's run the application. And let's try it again. Let's scroll here horizontally and we do have all our fixed labels of my group by. Finally, we have the option for the summary. So we can scroll here. We are editing here the grid, then the summary. So grid, then summary settings. All right. Then we need to scroll down here a little bit. And here we have the fixed column. This is not a new option, but this one it is, fixed column hover. So let's try it. And here we have our summary and here we have our pins. All right. And we can scroll here and that's it. Okay. So finally we have here, two types of new icons for order your columns. So we have this one for order your text columns, for example, from A to Z. And then we have here the numeric one from 1 to 9, this one right here. And this is pretty easy to use. Let me show you. Inside your grid, you should go to the sorting options. Then you can scroll here a little bit. And here we will have two new options. We can select these icons from your theme. And you can also set up here directly from Font Awesome, and we have here different types, so you can just click on it and that's it. the numeric one and the alphanumeric ones. Alright, so, and if you want to apply all these settings to your project, I'm talking about the fixed columns and these new icons, you can check the description and check for express edit. So I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial, and I see you in the next one.